Charger Lab got an original GaN charger for 100 watts laptops from Lenovo. It comes with an integrated cable, and the length of the cable is about 1.8 meters. It is overall black. The case is made of fire-retardant PC with a matte surface. It adopts a three-prong design, and the specs info are printed below the prong. Model is ADL100UDGC3A. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts 1.6 amp 50 or 60 hertz. It can support output of 5 volts 3 amp 9 volts 3 amp 15 volts 3 amp and 20 volts 5 amp. There is a groove at the connection between the output cable and the adapter for protection. The case of the USB-C connector is equipped with a circular groove to facilitate user plugging and unplugging. The size of it is about 62 by 63 by 32 millimeters. The length of the output cable is about 178 centimeters. The weight is about 234 grams. ChargerLab Power's EKM003C shows that USB-C can support PD3.0 PPS QC5 and DCP charging protocols. And it has four fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amp 9 volts 3 amp 15 volts 3 amp 20 volts 5 amp and two sets of PPS. Next, let's start to take it apart to see its internal components and structure. First, remove the input and output covers. The input and output wires are connected by soldering. Push the PCBA module out. The PCBA module is wrapped with aluminum sheets for heat dissipation. Cut off the wires. And remove the heat sinks. This is the solder joint for the heat sink. The PCBA module is filled with potting compound for heat dissipation. And there is a mylar sheet between the heat sink and the PCBA module for insulation. Remove the heat sink and mylar sheet and clean up the PCBA module. There is a small PCB on the edge of the PCBA module, which is the bridge rectifier and PFC circuit. The back of the PCBA module has a hybrid flyback controller and two MOSFETs. ChargerLab found it adopts a PFC plus HFB hybrid flyback topology with a wide range output voltage. Next, we will take a look at each component starting from the input end. The input fuse is from Conker MST series and is used for input overcurrent protection. 3.15 amp 250 volts. The safety X2 capacitor is from SCC. 0.33 microfarad. The common mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires and insulated with a bracket and tape. The other common mode choke is also wound with magnet and insulated wires. And it's also insulated with a bracket. There are two bridge rectifiers on the small PCB. 3 amp 1000 volts for each. The specification of this thin film capacitor is 0.68 microfarad. The other film capacitor has a specification of 1 microfarad. The filter inductor is wounded with magnetic ring and insulated by a bracket. The PFC controller is from Onsemi. It is based on an innovative Valley synchronized frequency full back method. The VSFF maximizes the efficiency at both nominal and light loads. The PFC MOSFET is from GaNNext and adopts PQFN 8x8 package. It has a high repetitive input voltage tolerance of plus or minus 20 volts. 650 volts 150 milliohm. The magnetic core of the PFC boost inductor is wrapped with copper foil shield and insulated with tape. The PFC rectifier is from STMicro and adopts DPAK package. 10 amp 600 volts. The electrolytic capacitor is from NCC. 450 volts 82 microfarad. The HFE controller is from Infineon and adopts PG-DSO-14 package. It is a hybrid flyback controller. It integrates 600 volts high voltage startup cell for fast charging and can drive both high and low side MOSFETs. The filter capacitor that supplies power to the master control chip is from Aisher. 35 volts 47 microfarad. This MOSFET is from Infineon and adopts thin PK 8x8 package. 650 volts 185 milliohm. The HFB MOSFET is from STMicro and adopts DPAK package. 650 volts 380 milliohm. The magnetic core of the transformer is insulated by tape. The optocoupler from Lydian is used for output voltage feedback regulation. The synchronous rectifier controller is from MPS and adopts TSOT23-6 package. It supports multiple working modes. The synchronous rectifier is from Infineon and adopts PG-TDSON-8 package. 100 volts 4 milliohm. The TVS diode used to absorb surge over voltage is from Littelfuse. This is the solid capacitor for output filtering. 680 microfarad 25 volts. The electrolytic capacitor has the same specifications. The protocol chip is from Welltrend. It supports USB PD 3.0 and QC 4+. It supports multiple protection functions. The VBUS MOSFET is from APEC and adopts PMPAK 3x3 package. 30 volts 4.2 milliohm. Well, those are all components of the Lenovo 100 watts GaN charger. It adopts a three-prong design with a 1.8 meter long output cable which can meet most usage scenarios. After taking it apart, we found it adopts a PFC plus HFB hybrid flyback topology with a wide range output voltage. The PCBA module is filled with potting compound to enhance heat dissipation. And it is also wrapped with aluminum sheets. It is optimized for high-power continuous output scenarios to improve performance. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.